So then when somebody says, oh, that's a beautiful painting, instead of saying, yeah, I got it at the gallery, they could say, well, you know, the guy who did this has a big, interesting story that let me tell you about. You'll meet some of these people, and their stories are as amazing as their artwork.
And I've been talking to a few of these artists, and they do have amazing stories. And actually, I want to take a walk over here to one of them, Austen Brantley. He just graduated from Berkeley High School, and I am amazed when I look at your work. These sculptures he made, tell me, how long have you been doing this?
This is my second year doing it.
2 years?
Yes, ma'am.
Are you telling me the truth?
Yes.
So tell me, how do you become such an accomplished artist at such a young age? What's behind this?
You really just learn from trial and error, and you just try to fix your mistakes, and you give it all you got.
And tell me a little bit about, sounds like you're really going for your dreams. What's your advice to other people who have a passion for art?
Just pursue it. You can't give up, no matter what discouragement you have to just keep going.
And you just graduated from high school. What's next?
San Francisco, the Academy of Art University.
Well, congratulations, and thank you so much for giving us your time. 2 years. I want you to take a look again. He's been doing art for 2 years, and he made these. You are going to see some amazing stuff out here at the Stars and Stripes Festival, meet some very interesting people, and hey, enjoy some music.
Hi, I'm Austen Brantley. I'm 18 years old, and I'm from Detroit, Michigan. My goal is to go to the San Francisco Academy of Art University, and my dream is to become a sculptor.
My name's Gail Pfeiffer, and I'm a professor of ceramics here at Oakland Community College. I've been a professor here, I've been teaching ceramics for 20 years, and I've been a practicing artist before that, mainly in ceramics. I first met Austen actually several weeks ago when he was taking a class in the sculpture studio, and he came in and asked me for a critique on his work. And I turned the corner to walk into the room, and I was totally stunned by what I saw. There were three fantastic clay sculptures, busts of figures that Austen was working on that were incredibly masterful. And when I began to talk with Austen and I discovered how old he was, being only 17, and already you could see without a doubt the vision and the skill, the wisdom that he had just with the figure itself that he was bringing to his works was just quite amazing. And I was very excited and talked to him about having him work with me in a field study class, which is an independent study class. And we were able to arrange that. And you can tell just in the bit that I've been working with him how excited and passionate he is about learning about not just the figure, but how clay, the technical aspect of it, the expression that he can explore in this media. And for someone this age, I've never seen anyone quite as talented and driven as Austen is with this medium. he is a dream student. I mean, he is really a student that every teacher just wishes that they had at some point in their career. You should go get him, Austen.
My name's Bernadette Zahara Marcos. I'm a sculptor from Farmington Hills, Michigan. I've been sculpting for 40 years or more, and I have private students in my studio to teach them sculpture. And Austen is amazing. He is so full of energy, and he has a lot of promise. And I see great things for him in the future. He works very, very hard, even dreams about sculpting. So I am so happy to be able to teach him. And he is showing great promise, and look what he's done here in a short time.
One of the reasons Frederick Hart's work inspires me is because of the scale. This is actually minuscule to the actual size of the complete piece, and he worked on it as one of his first actual projects that really got him started, and many would say is his masterpiece. And honestly, that's inspired me.
I've learned so much and been blessed so often that I really feel like I need to give back. So with a piece that I actually started about maybe 10 or 12 months ago, was a piece I actually donated to the school I graduated from, Berkeley High School. And unfortunately, one of my classmates passed away, and I felt like there needed to be a reconciliation for that. And I sculpted a piece to sort of represent him and also be a symbol that if something happens like that tragedy, we need to have a positive outlook on it. And the fact that we always remember that person and always cherish that he was alive. And that's why I made the piece.